Blessed day, and welcome to another film in the series Plodders Lost. That's the wrong series, isn't it? Plodding the Dales with Plodders Lost. It's been so long. I mean, it's 2021. The last time I did a significant walk was Christmas, but you've seen that one. And before that was my version of the Dales Way, which was in 2019. What the hell's happened since then? Right. Today I'm doing one of my special routes. Well, it was special on the map. I'll let you know how special it is when I get to the end. This is the Rash in Kettlewell. You may have heard it for the cycling races, the Tour de Yorkshire and the Tour de France. I think they came up here. And it's steep going, it's 1 in 4. Kettlewell is just down there behind those trees. As you can see, it's misty. It's raining. I'm going up here, this bridle way. It says Coverdale 3.5, Starbottom 3.5. Everywhere's 3.5. I'm not going 3.5, I'm going further than that. I'm going to go up here towards Buckton Pike and past the memorial. And just before I get to Buckton Pike, I'm going to go right somewhere and then follow something along the edge of the hills towards Bishopdale, because that's my target today, Bishopdale. But because you've been demanding some of my films, I'm camping there, as you can tell by the still too heavy backpack. And then I'm walking back via, I think, Coverdale tomorrow. I'll tell you more about that if I make it to Bishopdale today. The weather's been beautiful all summer until I plan a walk. Right. This is going to be steep going. You can see this bridle way quite clearly as you drive in from Grassington towards Kettlewell. Up on the hills on the right hand side of the road, it goes straight up. Looks fun. I'll let you know shortly. Quite a leg-warming start. About 20 minutes to get up and it just starts to level out on this bridle way. As you can see, I'm going that way. Those hills at the back there are Old Cope Moor. That's Upper Wharfdale along that valley there. If you go down there, there's Kettlewell at the bottom of the hill. Follow the road or the river along that way, you come to Kilnsea and Grassington. Those hills over there, the top in the mist, is Great Wernside. I think I've done one of those walks or on my series. I came out of Kettlewell and went up the edge of the hill there. You can just see a crevice down there. And up to Hag's Dyke, which is like a scout's outdoor pursuit activity, hunting, fishing, lodge centre. And then straight up the hill to the top of Great Wernside. Over the back of Great Wernside is Angrim Reservoirs and Scar House. I think it's called Scar House Reservoir. I came up the back once as well when I walked from Pateley Bridge and then I came down into Kettlewell. Was that the one where I was singing, "War, what is it good for?" That was it, yeah. Thank you. On one of my walks, I walked along the top and they came down, and you can see just there where it's a bit brighter in the distance, there's a road, and I crossed over the road and then I walked round here and I went to Buckton Memorial, Buckton, and then down to Cray, had a pint there, along to Buckton, had a pint there, Starbottom, that's where I went to that that pub, the Temperance Inn, or whatever it was called, they don't serve ale, crap pub. Then I came to the Fox and Hounds. Was that closed? That was closed, so I might not have had a pint there. It's open now. And then I walked into Kettlewell and had a pint there. Unfortunately, today's not going to be that good. Quite straightforward, you just literally follow the bridle way. You can just see it snaking green through there down towards the valley in the distance, and then you get to a point and it comes sharp left back on yourself, and then you follow it around this way. There is a finger post there with three directions. You don't want to go that way. I started going that way. You don't want to go that way. You want to come back to the finger post and come this way. Me plotting on the map wasn't so accurate this time. In the distance, in the mist, Great Whernside. And this way, Old Cope Moor. And has other various names, but I like the word moor. Down the bottom in this valley will be Starbottom and the Fox and Hounds pub. Nice pub. Well, it's open. Aren't they all? You only come a couple of hundred yards along that bridle way and you come to a gate just there. Come through the gate and turn immediately right, because if you don't, you'll follow the bridle way down there to Starbottom itself. There's a little gap in the wall, but as you can see, there's also a track runs up here. This will take us up to the memorial, Buckton Memorial. I've been there before. Grim weather, innit? Global warming, my arse. It's freezing. Upper Wharfdale down there, the Dale's Way sneaks along this route and then goes off to the left into the sunny distance. Been glorious weather for blooming weeks. The very 2 days I picked to go on a walk. It's that fine rain as well. It's not too bad, I'm not too wet, but it's pretty straightforward. There's a footpath. You just follow all along from over the hills over that way. It just snakes its way along the side of the hill. And when you get to here, there's a big gill and a valley here going down to Starbottom. There's a track over there as well. You can go along. Well, this is Starbottom Fell. And along here we turn right and then make our way up to the memorial. That spitty rain does get you wet. It's pretty windy along there. The wind always seems to come from over in that direction. On a clear day, you've got some lovely views here. And the heather's all purple. I've not seen any heather up here yet, but over in Littondale, when I was there yesterday, you could see the sun on the heather. It's purple, it's beautiful. Whereas I'm purple now with the cold. Well, after 2 hours and 20 minutes, you get to the Buckden Memorial. Thanksgiving to God. May the Lord open. It's quite a long slog up that there, just at the end, in the mist. There's a couple of people come up to the memorial. I'm not sure which way I'm going, actually. I only come here because I don't want to catch COVID. No, seriously, I don't. Missus will kill me again. Right, so I'm going to have a look at my GPS. Oh, bit of sun. Going to have a look at my GPS and find out which way I'm going now, because I think I go up towards Buckden Pike, which is on the other side of this wall. And then I hang a right, whatever hang a right means. I'm not sure, I'll let you know when I'm hanging it. You can go to the memorial if you like, but my advice is don't bother, because you've got to then come back. There's a gate over there, you might see there's a few people that are there. As you come through that gate, if you turn left and walk along that wall, you'll come to the memorial. But then, it's nice to go and see the place, but then walk back along to the gate again. And then, if you're coming from the memorial, turn left. If you're coming from the gate, just go straight ahead through the gate and don't turn left up to the memorial. Have you got that? I'm lost myself. Right. You come up the track to that gate. If you turn left when you come through the gate, you get to the memorial. Don't bother. Just go straight ahead. You can see it's clear. I'm thinking this route. There's a footpath on the map. Not sure how frequently it gets used, but I can see an old stones and stuff as if something's been along here at some point in time. Nice big drop down here into the valley. Not Buckden, Great Wernside. And I think it's Little Wernside, as you can see. It's just there. Can you not see it? Look, it's just, don't know. I'm going slow today. I'm not used to walking with a backpack on. It's not as heavy as normal. Still heavy though. Find somewhere sheltered up here. And have my lunch. Right, that's quite difficult terrain that. I'm on open ground at the moment.
or as you probably know it, off-piste.
You come along that hill in the distance, you can just see it in the fog, in the mist. And it's like a bridle way, but then it goes onto like a sheep's type of footpath. You know, just a very, very faint. And it carries on taking you up the hill, as if you're going back to Buckton Pike, or just underneath it. But you've got to make your way down across open ground. There is a footpath on the map, but there's hardly anything you can see. I've come across, just at the top here, you can see a big post sticking out there. I've got to that post, and then I follow the little trail down to this post, down here. And you can't see at the moment, but just in the mist around that area over there, there's a track. It's like a gamekeeper's track or a shooter's track or, you know, land track or whatever. It comes across here. And I think it joins up just below there, and that's where you're heading to. That's called Deepdale. I think it's Deepdale Gill or Deepdale End, just around this area. So if you have a look on the map, you'll see a faint footpath, but it's not visible on the ground. As I say, you've got to just drop down, and you'll see on the map a track or a bridle way, more defined, going along this way. And when you drop down, as I say, there's a couple of posts. How long they'll be there, God knows. Well, as I say, you can just see Snake in there. Well, you might not be able to see because of the mist. And I think it comes round here, and I join it down here somewhere, and then I follow it left. Oh, what did I have for lunch? Oh, home cooked ham. Oh, blessed fruit. Beautiful. Couple of baps. I love a couple of baps. Or have you heard that argument? What you call them? Is it a bread bun? Is it a bread cake? Is it a bap? A balm cake, a bread roll, a stotty. I can't be arsed. Just give us it with some meat in it and no butter. I don't like butter. Oh, look at the sun down there. It's always down there, isn't it? Well, it's not really sun, is it? But I think that road snakes through to Leyburn. It's the one that comes out of Starbottom up the Rake and works its way down there. I think that might be Coverdale. God knows. Okay, the mist's lifted a bit, so once you see those posts, they are on the footpath and you can just follow it down. You can see it's quite worn. There's another post. There's another post there in the distance, and then one in the distance. But the track I was referring to, if you see it, you can just see the cutting into the side of the hill there. It works its way around. That's the one you're aiming for from down up here. So you just cut down and eventually you'll come to it. And I'm going right along there in the distance where you can see the scree on the left hand side. Just on the top there's a path. And it looks like there's some heather, and you can just see a little trace of the path coming through the hill there. I think that's all part of the same track. Over there, I think that is Little Wernside, and then it works up its way over here. Well, that's Little Wernside, and then it goes right over to Great Wernside over in that direction. So I'm going down here, right along this path, right on the edge of that hill in the distance on the right hand side there. And then I work my way back over the hill down into a place called New Biggin, or near New Biggin, Street Head Inn. There's a campsite at the side there, and there's a pub there, and they sell Plodder's Best Bitter. My name's written all over it. Better bloody had me. Thank you. you just keep on that track for miles and miles, and then when you can see this t-shirt in the distance across the heather, you just go for it. Go for the stones, don't follow the track, because it takes you somewhere else. That somewhere else is very nice, but it isn't where you need to be, which is here, which is Wasset Fell. I can't guarantee that t-shirt will be here, but it does have made in 1974 on it, so it's doing quite well. M&S. It'd be lovely if the sun was out, because the heather's all nice and purple up here. And you can just see on the hill in the sun over there, you can just see the heather, the dark bit, nice and purple in the sun. I'm going down here somewhere to New Biggin, and then through, that's only a little hamlet, through New Biggin, just on the other side is a place called Street Head Inn and Street Head Caravan Camping Park. And in that pub, under his eye, blessed be the fruit, I think you think I've gone all religious, haven't you? Haven't I? Or do you? I haven't. I've been watching that series, The Handmaid's Tale, and it's left me quite disturbed. I'm always disturbed anyway, but I'm emotionally hollow. What a grim series that is. I'm coming up to about number 3, episode 12. She's just started to kick a little bit of ass. It's someone on the head with an ornament, killed him. I've been waiting for that for 3 series. Anyway, it's just as bleak up here, so don't bother coming. I haven't done this for a while, so it's taken me about an hour longer than I expected. It's going to be about 11.5 miles, and I've been going 6 hours now. So I've not had the big backpack on for 2 years. My boots are killing. I think that's the terrain with the stones under your feet. It's so hard, there's no give. But then when you get on the heather, it's nice and soft, but my God, it's harder walking on that stuff. Anyway, enough of this. We're off down. See what the scram's like. Have some of that beer. You can have one with me. You come in. Come on then. You come down under those trees there into the top of what's called New Biggin. So when you're on the Wasset Fell, there's no clear path down really. You've just got to follow your nose. The most important thing is make sure your nose is pointing in the right direction. Just look at the buildings in the valley below. Point your nose that way and go that way. You'll find what looks like a sheep's track all the way down, and a few gates to go through, and then you come into New Biggin, which looks like rather nice place. Lovely big barn there, nice one there, and a nice house there. Oh, new one here, I'm getting a new one, 2000. Well, it's not new, is it? God, it's 21 years ago. Oh. Just at the end of here is the pub. Under his eye, blessed fruit, blessed day, the Lord open. God, there's some crap phrases in that series. Really irritating as well. Blessed day, commander. Flowers. Always cheer you up, flowers, don't they? Well, it's just coming up to 5 o'clock, and I've reached my final, obviously not my final destination. I've reached my destination, the Street Head Inn. The campsite is just apparently round the side there. This is Bishop Dale in the sun all the way up here. The road goes through, and as far as I can see on the map, which doesn't necessarily mean it's true because I don't know how to read maps, I think it's a dead end. Oh, don't think it's open yet actually. The timing's all wrong if it's not open. I've booked the table for tonight, so what I'm going to do is set my tent up, take my boots off. My feet are killing. I shouldn't have attempted that. You know what, it could be 12 miles tops. It's tough going up to the top of Buckton and then just going along that track in these big heavy boots when I've not worn them for a while and having a backpack on. Tell you what, I'm knackered. I'd moan about my backpack being too heavy, but you've already heard that. I've done bugger all about it. Blessed pint under my eye. I can't stop saying those phrases. Neither can the missus. Every time she gives me dinner, I say, blessed fruit. Get up in the morning, blessed day. And then she beats me about and psychologically torments me. No, she doesn't. I'm losing it like that woman off Joseph. I'm going to start calling the missus off Plodder. Next time you see me, if I've got bruises, I called her off Plodder and she wasn't appreciative. Oh, this looks nice. Whoa, we should stay in one of them. Still in my crappy little tent. Sorry I didn't take you in the pub last night. The batteries are limited and there wasn't many charging points. In fact, there weren't any. My phone's low. So I've got a couple of batteries to hopefully last for today. And they don't half go through batteries, these GoPros. Anyway, had a nice steak. Lovely pint of Plodder's Best. I know you believe I had one of those. And not only that, I got chatting to the landlord and he was very accommodating because he's taken 6 miles off my route today at least. I was that knackered yesterday. I thought, I'm going to work over this hill to get onto the main route today. And I managed to sweet talk him into allowing me to, well, sweet talk him into giving us a lift to a place called Horse House. So it's probably about 4 miles short than what I was going to do, which that was probably going to be about 16 miles. So I'm still going to do about 10 miles today, and this is going to be quite tough today. So praise be the landlord. I don't start that again. Right, so I'm at, I think it's Arkleside. It's a little village just down the road from Horse House. Just come over this little bridge. I'll just follow the route along here and then I work my way up onto the hills and then I'm going up there, which I think eventually turns into Little Wernside and then Great Wernside. And now you know why I was desperate to shorten my route. So down there in the distance, that village there is Horse House. I planned to walk over these hills from the other side at Street Head. But it would have been 4 miles, well, a mile or so to Witton, West Witton, a bit along the road, another mile, and then I think 4 miles over the hills. That would have been six additional miles on top of, I think, 10 or so I'm going from here. And yesterday, my feet were killing because I've not worn these boots for 2 years. And I've not worn this backpack for 2 years. So I'm not as fit as I should be. Anyway, rather than do that, I got the landlord who was going to Kettlewell, because you go along this road here to Kettlewell. He was going to Kettlewell, and so I said, can I have a lift? Not to Kettlewell, it was tempting. But I got to Horse Houses, where I would have actually joined, come over those hills anyway. You walk along the road from Horse Houses into Arklingside, over a little bridge, through a little, past a few houses, and you come to this bridleway. And it's a bridleway signpost, it's 3.5 miles to Scarhouse Reservoir that way. But I'm not going to Scarhouse Reservoir, I'm going up here into the mist. I'm looking for some gorillas. Can you tell by the way I'm walking? I'm knackered. We've got a mile. Maybe a mile and a half. I'm just sat having lunch just down in one of these little hollows out of the wind, because it's very windy when you're up there. I don't know whether you can see, there's a little tip of a reservoir, that's Angrim Reservoir. And on one of my walks, I came from Paintley Bridge, which meant I came over the hills from in the distance, you might see some fields right in the distance, and then over this hill down to Scarhouse Reservoir, and then along the path on the other side of Angrim, and then back over here. And then there's a wall on this hill. I walked all the way along that wall and went up onto Great Wernside and over into Kettlewell. Great Wernside's under that cloud. I'm going under that cloud. That's why I'm sat here having some lunch now. As you go up the hill there, you can see the cloud base is right on the top of Wernside. So I think it's going to be cold, damp, and not very good views. I've not seen anyone. Yesterday, I saw some shooters just as I got up to Buckden, but that's a popular shooting ground by Buckden Pike. And then some at the memorial, some saga louts. I had to stay away from them. You probably noticed I didn't want to catch COVID. You don't want to catch COVID, trust me. I think I've had it, you know, yesterday. Well, I didn't have it yesterday, but I think I had that long version of it. What's it called? Long COVID. No, I didn't have that. Long John Silver, because I was walking as if I only had one leg. I think the wooden one had woodworm in it. My feet are a lot better today. I put my boots on the right way. On the right feet. That was a killer. I'm glad I've cut off a few miles today because I'm not fit enough to carry that backpack out 2 days on the trot. I've hardly done anything for ages. Well, proper walking in anger, as I call it. Right, so we're going to have me 2-day-old cheese sandwich. I made these yesterday before I set off walking, and they taste and look just as bad as they did yesterday. Bap barm cake, oh, don't start me. Bread roll with cheese, no butter or margarine, don't like butter or margarine, nothing else because it would make the bread go soggy over the day. So it's hard to masturbate, masculate. I can't think of the word. You know, when you move your mouth, and you chew, and you make fluid in your mouth. God, you know what? I'm losing it. Masticate. Masturbate. Where'd you get masturbate from? Masticate. Kochenthwaite. I see. God, that is hard to swallow. The water I've got tastes awful. I use one of those camelbacks. It's more like a camel's arse, to be fair, because the water tastes disgusting. Once you've used it for a few times, it all goes chemically tastes, you know, plasticky inside. It's bloody disgusting. It's not getting any brighter, is it? It's shite. Sun's out over there. Right, I better go. Would have choked to death. I'll see you on the hill. So it's now about 20 past two, the year of our Lord 2021, under his eye. And I'm at Wernside, or rather Great Wernside. Here we are, all that way, and it's just a big load of friggin' rocks. The route actually is it's quite clear, but when you get over Little Wernside and then you come down, it's a bit boggy underfoot. And it's been dry for weeks round here, apart from today and yesterday. I can imagine it's quite treacherous. So, you know, you're going to get muddy, wet feet. When you go up though, climbing up to get up to Wernside and then Great Wernside, there's a pasture or something called Wernside there. It's good. It's just like that non-stop for ages. It's about three false peaks or summits. You get there and you go, oh, fuck. You get to the next one and you go, oh, fuck. You get to the next one and you go, fucking repeats. I hate repeats. Right. There's the trick point. I can't even be asked to go and touch it. I've touched it before. Oh, sorry. Look, just because I'm a professional, I wasn't hard, was I? I thought I had to scramble over them. Is that better? God, look at all these boulders. Who's dumped these up here? They are massive. I was stood behind those rocks because it's quite windy here. And the mist, the clouds very wet and moist. Whoa. So it took me from about 9:30. Took a 20 minute break for my sandwiches to get here. And I'm still in one piece. Just working the Swiss or something like that. Oh, Jesus, my legs won't bend. So now all I have to do is go all the way down. But, and this is a big but, when I get to the bottom here, there's a village called Ketel Well. And in that village, there's three hostelries for members of the public like me. Well, basically, pubs. There's three pubs down there. So, they're bound to sell something I really need right now. Anadine. I've not had Anadine for years, babe. Who has Anadine? It's all like ibuprofen now, isn't it? Or paracetamol. Oh, Christ, I'll have to stand up. Oh. Right, so I'm going to have a glug of water from this camel's arse pouch I've got. I'll have some, one of my favourites, it's those Aldi Snickers. They're not Snickers, I don't know what they're called, but they're their version and they are better. I've saved that since Christmas. It's my main Christmas present, just the one. I was expecting to see more people up here today. Because there are quite a few dickheads in this world, you know. I'm not the only one. Right. I'll take a photo so as I can show my friends, well, two of them, in the Caribbean sunning themselves. Oh, I'm just so tired. Anyway. I think it might be about 1.5 to 2 hours to get down from here, to be fair. I can't remember, but the pace I'm going, it could well be that one, that time. Right, so I've seen a bit on the way down. We've been here before. This is Hag's Dyke. It's a scout outdoor pursuit activity, hunting, fishing, making knots and getting badgers centre. I was in the Cubs. Dib, dib, dib. Anyway, we've mentioned this building before as well. Blessed be the highest chapel in the country. See the fingers? The scout symbol. This stained glass, the door's closed, but if you're inside and you're looking this way, it's 1947 to 1997. Hagdyke Chapel. Well, it must have died in 1997. Didn't know chapels can die. Under his eye, R.K. Law. R.K. Law. Must have been Scouse, mustn't he, the chief the chief rabbi, the chief rabbi of the Cubs and the Scouts, R. Kayla. Where did they get chief rabbi from? Chief rabbi, chief knobhead. That's me, by the way, not. Right, that should be the pub and the route to it, the quickest one. You can get into this religious tongue, can't you? What were all the phrases? Can you remember the phrases? I think I mentioned yesterday, didn't I? I've been emotionally hollowed out by that film, The Handmaid's Tale. I just think tonight I can watch some more of it. I hope it's a time she starts kicking ass seriously, because boy, do they need their asses whooping. Blessed day. Under his eye. May the Lord open. Open what? The door to the pub, that's all I can think of. Oh, there's another one, blessed fruit. Have you seen the shelves? The women, hang on, this is a blooper, isn't it? The women are not allowed to read. So if you go into that shop where they all hang out, those handmaids and the Marthas, under extremely high guard, because it's very valuable, the produce in there, because they're suffering from Brexit. You can't get milk of HEV drivers. Anyway, they're in there and they spend hours. There's no writing on the bottle. It's just a picture of a lemon. So it's a good idea. It's got lemon juice in it or something, right? And they spend hours looking at it and putting it back. And then they go to the next page, it's got an apple on. And they put it back. You just go in. What do you want? Lemon juice, lemon juice. Apple juice. I'm off. Under his eye, under the shelf. Under the shelf? Right. Got to go through this gate here. And then it's a nice track down into Kettlewell, where I'll be reading the labels on the beer, looking for Plodder's Best Bitter. And it better be on, or hell on earth is going to occur in Kettlewell today. I can tell you that much. Because the missus loves Plodder's Lost. I mean, they don't serve everyone. Shit's going to hit the fan. I'll have to start wearing long trousers to hide the bruises. She'll kill me, say no. No, she will. As promised, at the end of every day, we arrive at a pub that serves Plodder's Best Bitter. The gentleman and the lady opposite are dying for a pint, aren't you? But it's served all over the Dales, as you know, from all of these videos, you can get a pint of this at every pub that I go to. Flodder's Best Bitter. So it's about, what, have you got the right time, please? It's 16:14 exactly. I set off at 9:30 this morning, and it's taken all that time to get here with 20 minutes break. So I'm glad I missed out those first 4 miles, because I wouldn't be getting here for another 2 or 3 hours. And by then, I'm dead to drink it all. You go and ask for a pint now. It doesn't know, it's £7 a pint. £3 stretch to me. So I hope you enjoyed the past 2 days. I'll knock this video together, put it on the YouTube channel, and we're back in business. I forgot to mention, didn't I? One final thought. Blessed be the pint. Under his eye.